This
is Daily Planet. Today, immersed in 100 million pixels, this virtual reality room has the highest resolution in the world. So why is it being used to design a better cotton picker?
Plus, scanning a mummy to solve a mystery. Is this ancient Egyptian a man or a woman? Or is it who anthropologists think it is? One scan will set the record straight.
And building the UK's most powerful nuclear submarine ever. We're going to find out how computer-assisted design is changing how these machines are made. Hey, welcome to Daily Planet. I'm Kim Dick-Pianney.
And I'm Jay Ingram. Also on the show today, we're going to hear about one man's plans to head to the North Pole with a sled on a 2,000-kilometer journey measuring ice all along the way.
We're also going to warm things up by bringing a powerful heat lamp into the studio and show you how a new coating for windows can actually help keep heat out.
But we kick things off by stepping into a six-sided cube that looks more like an immersive video game than anything else. But it's a lot more than that. This computer room is much different than any you've ever been in before. Like no other room on the planet.
It's the highest resolution display, immersive display device in the world. It's almost 100 million pixels.
All four walls, the ceiling and the floor have every last centimeter covered with video. They call it the six-sided cave, or C6.
Humans can process mass amounts of information if it's presented in a very sensible, organized way, and we feel that 3D virtual reality is a way to do that. When we're in the real world, you don't have, you know, huge blind spots. It's not like you can only see this little field of view in front of you. You can see all around you. So we're trying to mimic that in the virtual world.
That video on the wall is made by a digital projector designed for a movie theater. Four of them are needed for each wall. That's a total of 24 projectors at more than $100,000 each. But the design of the room is the trickiest part. Look at the floor. It's a movie screen that people are going to walk on.
You need to have a transparent surface that's also strong enough and durable enough to support multiple people inside the environment. And then you also have to have that elevated enough so that you can project from underneath there. And that's why this facility is as tall as it is, so that they can get projectors underneath as well as projectors from above projecting onto the ceiling.
Looks like the ultimate video game system, right? It's actually designed for much more serious work.
We experience the world as 3D, and so when we're trying to make decisions about the world, making decisions in 3D is a lot better way to do it. What we have here is we've been using this to design a number of Deere products. Today we're looking at cotton pickers.
Yep, the most advanced virtual reality room on the planet is being used to create a better cotton picking machine.
The challenge is we want to pick the cotton up off the ground. We put it into a small cotton conveyance system that takes it back to the basket. See, what's happening is you're getting a recirculation region where it separates, and that starts to close off that duct. And so what we did then is we went in, we moved that around and said, well, what happens when I change this?
The time spent in the C6 has paid off.
We reduced the energy cost of this by about 25%. We increased the flow rate by about 25%. We've increased the suction that's picking up the cotton, so it's less likely to plug. And it's a lot quicker than welding it together, testing it out, and seeing whether you liked it or not.
There's even more stuff down on the farm they're using the C6 for, things you'd never guess.
So what we're looking at here is we're looking at a hog enclosure. This is a typical hog enclosure. And the questions are, how do we design the fans and the ventilation system to take the best possible care of the hog? Immediately we see we've got this problem with this recirculation region in here. It's like playing a game. You can have the game of design the hog shelter and get it right, and then you can go build it for real.
Engineers aren't only using this multi-million dollar marvel for cotton and pigs. It's also being used for life and death situations like war zones.
We call the Battlespace. This application allows me to do command and control for a large air military engagement. Well, they're flying these over in Iraq and Afghanistan right now, and the pilots are in Las Vegas. Here, I can look at thousands of square miles, and we would call it typically the God's eye view. And any intelligence that we gather time as the engagement is taking place can be fed into this simulation. But our vision is that you would control swarms of these things, hundreds, thousands of them simultaneously. There's no other way to do this right now.
It's not all so serious. The C6 can be used for fun and games too. In this one, the viewer flies right inside the cells of a plant.
This is a soybean cell. The problem is there's been a virus, came from Europa, and it's infected all the plants. All plants are dead, except there's one plant living, and actually in that plant there's only one living cell. And so the player is going to have to go inside the cell and save it. So this green thing is a chloroplast. There's a starch grain right there. You can see in the background that's the membrane.
Maybe saving this plant will even teach students a thing or two.
You can read that in a textbook. It's not that exciting. But if you're playing that in a video game, wow. In this new C6 in particular, it's amazing because, you know, I've never been inside a cell. So I think that kids could learn a lot more biology than just from a textbook.
For engineers who really want to take the plunge into another world, these 3D goggles make the whole experience even more surreal.
The end user sees the 3D effect when they're wearing a pair of these 3D glasses, which basically have the ability to shutter one eye or the other. And we sync that with filters that are installed on the projectors that also block the one projector, left eye projector or the right eye projector. And it does this all faster than your mind can tell. So as far as your mind is concerned, you are seeing three-dimensional images. We frequently have people that are bouncing into the wall. One of the ideals with the C6 is you don't have to rotate the world, which breaks your realism. You rotate as you normally would inside the real world. So you can get in here, you can get turned around, you have no idea which is the door, which was the front screen, or where you came in.
I've changed the pitch angle of something, and I see how is it different? Does it have more lift? Is it blowing more dust around? Is it picking up more cotton? Because you can't really figure out the dimensions unless you experience it like you experience life. Looking at a picture doesn't tell you how close things are together. Standing between them in 3D does.